Dear friend, I haven't really talked to anyone outside of my family all summer, but tomorrow is my first day, and I really want to turn things around this year.
You know, they say if you make one friend on your first day, you're doing okay.
Hey, freshman toad! Look at him! Come on, hop! Let's move it, boys!
If my English teacher is the only friend I make today, that would be sort of depressing.
So, Charlie, this is what fun looks like.
Welcome to the Island of Misfit Toys.
I loved this movie, as I just said. It was such a breath of fresh air. Really, you know, emotional at the same time. But what does it mean to have the film play at TIFF, especially because it's so personal to you?
You know, there really aren't words. I have to say, I know Toronto very well, and I know they love movies here. And to bring it here, of all places, where it's not so much about the hype, but it's about the artistry, and the fans are real fans, it's the best.
And having Stephen as the director, as well as the writer of the book, that must have helped, because you all must have realized you're on the right track.
Yes, absolutely. It's a very rare treat when you get to work with or you just talk to the novelist of a book when you're making a movie, let alone have him direct you every day. And he was very open, and he just said, shoot, ask whatever you want, and I'll answer all your questions. And as an actor, that's one of the greatest gifts that you can have.
Emma, I love Sam's tunnel moment.
Yay.
It's almost like she goes into the tunnel, one person comes out, another one. For you, what was the film role where you felt changed at the end? Like a tunnel.
This one,
yeah,
for sure. And like, that was the perfect metaphor for me. I really did feel like I changed when I went through that tunnel. It was weird. I don't know how to explain it. Getting to spend 6 weeks in Pittsburgh with this particular group of people making this particular movie was the most freeing experience. One of the most freeing experiences of my life.
People love the book. Do you think the film will relate to that many people as well? I mean, I can definitely relate to being that age and going through high school.
He was honest with it.
I think the voice is there, and it's straightforward, and it's from all of our hearts. Everybody that is involved, it's literally coming from the most raw, vulnerable, loving place from all of us. So I mean, that's there's something that is in there.
But Stephen, obviously you had people in mind when you were writing it, what the characters looked like.
Right.
How did the young cast live up to those
expectations? This cast legitimately exceeded everything I could have hoped. I told my casting directors, we didn't have a whole lot of time. I said, I want the best young cast since The Outsiders. You know, because I believe in setting impossible goals. And I have to say, they pulled off a bit of a miracle. And it's not even about the individual performances, although they're great. It's about the unspoken camaraderie and chemistry. You know, when you do a party scene, there you write five lines, but it's all the stuff that's going around it. And watching this group become real friends on and off screen, fantastic.
You see things, and you understand. You're a wallflower.
I didn't think anyone noticed me. I know there are people who say all these things don't happen. I know these will all be stories someday. But right now, we are alive. And in this moment, I swear, we are infinite.